Lorenzo, they're my cookies.
No, Janik. Seems like the cookie will be mine.
Hey guys, Janik here for Cinecom.net and welcome back to another Copycat Friday. And today we are going to Netflix and create. Wink, wink. I recently started with a new series called Warrior Nun and it was like 2 days ago and I really like it. And the best thing about it are the effects that we can recreate. Like this super cool vapor evading effect that we are creating today. I know it's not the best name, but you know what I mean. However, this series is full of effects and who knows, maybe we can do some more effects in the future. Let us know in the comments below if you would like that. But for now, hit the montage. Okay, shooting everything is quite simple. Just take out your tripod and then we are going to place our actor who is going to vaporize in the frame. Behind them we are placing a green screen to make it ourselves easier. Let the actor do his thing like jumping up a little bit and after this he can move out of the frame. Next up is the actor who will be swinging the bat. Again, place him in the frame and let him swing his bat. We are filming this separately because we really want the bat close enough to go through our vaporizing actor. And you also need to see the bat go through the actor in the end effect. And that is why we need these actors on separate clips. And once you have that, we can start with the post-production in After Effects. And the first thing you can do is place the swinging actor into a composition and the vaporizing actor above that. Of course, green key the vaporizing actor with the key light and mask out the rest of the clip. Look at that, the two actors are in the same scene. Now we will start with the vaporizing effect. Duplicate the clip of the vaporizing actor and look for the point just before they get hit by the bat. Now on this duplicate we can make a cut just before that hit. Next up, create a solid layer, place it on top of everything and also let it start at the same time as the duplicate. On the solid layer we will add the fractal noise effect and we are going to use this layer as a track mat for our duplicate vaporizing actor. So adjust the settings of your fractal noise to your likings, you can really do whatever you want. We went for the smeary fractal type and a larger scale. When you are done with the settings, set the track mat option of the duplicate vapor actor clip to Luma Mat and this will already give you a vaporizing effect. But we only want this around the place where the bat swings. So create a mask around this area and animate the mask so that it follows along with the bat coming in. And this already looks great, but we're also going to animate the fractal noise effect. On the point where the bat is in the middle of our vapor actor, the vaporizing needs to be at its maximum. Here you can create keyframes for the brightness and the contrast. Towards the beginning and the end, the vaporizing needs to disappear, so increase both the properties. Next, also animate the sub-rotation, the sub-offset and the evolution a little bit. Just enough to give that feeling that the vapor is moving in the same way as the bat's wings. All these animations happen within the time frame of 10 frames. So that's quite fast. And oh yeah, don't forget to ease in and ease out every keyframe. Next, we are going to work with the original vaporizing actor. We also need to mask this clip, otherwise you won't see any vapor. We are again going to do this with a track mat, this way we can roughen the edges of the hole we are creating. So create a new solid layer and place this in between the duplicate vapor clip and the original vapor clip. The first step, create an animated mask on the new solid, just like we did before. Once this is done, add the roughen edges effect to the new solid. Here again, play around with the settings until you have something you like. Then set the track mat option of the original vapor actor clip to alpha inverted mat and this will leave you with an already cool vapor effect. But we still have some details to go over. The first one is the angel halo in the back of our warrior nun. And well, I don't really have an angel halo, so I used this fire ring asset from Storyblocks video, which happens to be the sponsor of today. Storyblocks video is my go-to stock video website that I recommend to every filmmaker. And I'm not saying this because they are sponsoring us, no. I genuinely like the assets they have and they always provide me with something I need. From 4K stock clips to easy to customize After Effects templates. They have it all and more. So guys, take my word for it and start downloading from Storyblocks video. Because with paying one single price per year, you can download an unlimited amount of video assets. To start downloading, go to the first link in the description below. Okay, now that we have our ring, place it underneath the vaporizing actor. By enabling the 3D function, we can now position and rotate the fire ring in the correct spot on the back of our actor. Then set the blending mode of the ring to add, and next drag the glow effect to the fire ring for some extra glow. Again, set the settings to your likings. Now to give the fire ring some extra dimensions, we are going to make it bend together with the swing. Look for the liquify effect and drag that to the fire ring. Enable the animation for the distortion mesh on the moment that the ring becomes visible. Go 5 frames further in time, and now you can liquify the ring in the same direction as your swing is. Okay, we are almost there, guys. Stick by me. We just need a few more details. Select everything and pre-comp it all. Next, duplicate the pre-composed layer, and this duplicate we are going to use for some extra vaporizing. To do this, add the displacement map effect to the duplicate. Next, create a new solid layer, and here we can add the free video copilot plugin called Saber. Set the preset to Nebula and the glow color to white. Then create 3 or more mask lines on the solid layer. Go back in the Saber settings, and under the customized core property, you can set the core type to layer masks. Now change the track matte option of the duplicate pre-comp layer to Luma matte and animate the 3 mask lines to open up and close again. Now go back to the duplicate pre-comp layer and within the displacement effect change some settings. Set the displacement map layer to the Saber layer and also enable effects and masks. Next, set the horizontal and the vertical displacement to luminance, and now you can change the values of both the horizontal displacement as the vertical displacement. Then add the vector blur to the duplicate vapor clip and increase the amount and softness. Now the only thing you need to do is add some extra sparks and particles. And guys, you're in luck today. It just happens to be that we made these 2 assets especially for you. You can find the download link in the description below. And maybe, just maybe, there's even a project file in there. And that is how you make this vaporizing effect from Warrior Nun. And now for a Genic Fun Fact Fountain! Did you know that Warrior Nun is based on an American manga-style comic book named Warrior Nun Ariella? In the comic books, Ariella is a Valkyrie who renounced her pagan beliefs and turned to Jesus for salvation. That's dramatic. She then bears her soul into a mortal, and that way she lives on forever, taking a new mortal every time it dies. And well, the series is more or less the same, but instead of a warrior soul, you have an angel halo that makes a nun a warrior nun. So, potato potato. But I'm not going to spoil anything else, just go to Netflix and watch it. And that was it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching, I hope you learned something new today. Thank you Storyblocks Video for the support, and like always, stay creative.